I get a delivery. Now, I know a tool panel might not be the most exciting thing to unbox, but for me, this marks the start of something bigger. Let me explain. This house has been in my family for generations. My grandfather built this workshop and my dad kept it going. But now it's my turn to make it my own. Since moving here almost a year ago, I've been working to transform the house. And this space in particular caught my attention. I've always wanted a place where I could bring my ideas to life. But as it stood, it didn't quite fit me. I needed a space that was tailored to my needs, my tools, and my style. So I brought some friends over and we got to work. First, we cleared everything out and stripped the room down piece by piece. Once we had a blank slate, I jumped into my 3D modeling software to plan it all out beforehand. This helped me visualize how the space would look while keeping it as functional as possible. After playing around with a few layouts, I finally settled on this. From there, we got back to work. We added some wall studs to prepare for the new walls and also took the opportunity to prepare for the electrical wiring. Then we installed plywood panels and painted the walls, floor and ceiling. And that brings us to where I'm at right now. I finally have a workshop where I feel my creativity can flow. I got most of the tools I need, but of course, organization is key. And that's where this comes in. This is an Exponent tool panel. I already have some storage for my tools, but I hate the idea of searching for them when I need them. This should fix that. But of course, I'm not just gonna slap some hooks on it and call it a day. Where's the fun in that? Since I want to develop my design skills, I've decided to create custom holders for each tool. But first, I need to set some ground rules. 1. Simplicity. The design should be minimal, yet functional. No overcomplicated mechanisms, just clean, effective tool holders. 2. No overlapping. I shouldn't have to remove one tool to access another. Even if I only have one hand free, I should be able to grab what I need easily. 3. Future-proofing. I want this to be a long-term, evolving project. As my tool collection grows, I need to be able to adapt the panel accordingly. I got these mounts for reference, along with these plastic clips that lock the mount in place. I really like the idea of locking the mounts so they won't fall off when removing a tool. First, I need to take precise measurements of the board so I can design a prototype. Then, let's jump into my 3D modeling software, create a prototype and print. Once the prototype is ready, it's time to test it out. Now that we have a solid base for the mounting system, it's time to choose some of my most frequently used tools to start with. Each tool is different, so I need to make sure that the holders fit just right. Some tools need a simple bracket, while others might require some more complex designs. In some cases, I might use other people's designs as a template. In that case, I will make sure to add a link to their model in the description. Now, let's mount them and see how it looks. This is already looking way better, but this is just the beginning. As I get more tools and refine my workshop, I'll keep improving this system. Let me know in the comments if you have any ideas or suggestions for tool organization. And if you're into DIY, 3D printing or tech, don't forget to like and subscribe. More updates are coming soon. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.